Unique, one of a kind, fearless. A hard worker, determined, focused, driven, ambitious. It was my time to kind of show that I was more than a pretty face, and I started at 14 and I'm here at 22 and it's still not enough for me. I am Erica Mena. If I had to describe Erica's career in one word, it would definitely have to be gumbo. I just do everything. I do everything from the video stuff to, you know, Jennifer Lopez lookalike contest to hair campaigns to, you know, ad campaigns to commercials to movies to high fashion shows to, you know, magazines to, you know, mixtapes. I started at 14 and I'm here at 22 and it's still not enough for me. What really got me to want to be a model, I remember the first time I ever saw Cindy Crawford. I knew that instantly, just by the way she was, modeling and acting and all that stuff was definitely something I've wanted to do. I was 14 years old and I remember watching a special on TV, and it was on West Side Story. They showed Rita Moreno, who is basically the only real Puerto Rican that was casted, well, female, that was casted in that movie at that time. And I remember her saying in that interview right before the movie came back on, she knew, like, being this small girl in this big city, that whether she was younger or older, she eventually had to set out for what her heart told her. I remember the last thing that she said was that when she left home, it was the best thing she ever did. All of the lights. I kind of started doing, you know, little modeling, small gigs at 13 that my mom kind of started me in. I've just always been this camera loving creature. My first real modeling job, though, I have to say, was, oh, the In Gear magazine. And then after that, I think I landed a, yes, I was in the Sears catalog. To me, that was just, it was just fun. Show magazine actually asked me to become their first ever CoverGirl model. Apparently when I shot back with Smooth Magazine a few years prior, that whole concept that I did with them truly inspired one of the editors who eventually ventured off and did his own magazine to just kind of do that kind of concept and just, you know, just have nothing but a plain backdrop and just have a woman there and just, you know, at her best, just kind of show you that she's sexy and, you know, beautiful, and that's kind of what my spread gave. And eventually that rolled over and just inspired a whole magazine. I knew, even though I did music videos and so on and so forth, like I said earlier, it was just always a stepping stone for me. That's the only reason why I did it. And in this industry, there's so much to it, you know, to a foundation to become, I guess, the next big it thing, is that you kind of have to know everything, you know. Let's get right now that I'm here, baby. Show me a good time. My first music video was Rockefeller's Chris and Me's Can't Stop, Won't Stop, Young Guns. my whole experience on that video from beginning to end. I just remember just being new to the whole routine of it and really just standing there taking in everything from, you know, the number they gave me to stand in front of the camera to audition to the very time they called me to tell me I actually got the part. For me, it was liberating. It was, you know, I was actually going through the first big steps that, in my eyes, of getting the opportunity to be on TV and show myself to the world. They has to react like having an asthma attack when they see the plasma in back. I have 20 videos to date that I can actually take credit in being a part of, and to me that's just a great accomplishment. Overall, all the videos put together, I really wouldn't pick none of them because all of them to me symbolize something in my life and especially a stage in my career, because each one I learned something new and I gave something more or I did something less and, you know, kind of built myself as a performer and, you know, someone who I wanted to, you know, be and basically my brand. So hoarse, I just sound like money, baby. I should have been a Porsche. Paint looking like a sugar free Red Bull. I'm so paid, you know, I keep a pocket full. I really, really enjoyed the whole presentation and overall work that I put into for the Akon video. So paid. That was a whole 007 theme, and I admired that whole concept in that video just for the simple fact that it actually gave me an opportunity. I basically got to act, you know, and be Akon's accomplice and, you know, really just, without even talking, kind of make you believe that I was this, you know, special agent and, you know, I was out to help him, you know, get the diamond and, you know, all in all, I was the one who got, you know, screwed in the end. It was my time to kind of show that I was more than a pretty face, and after all the years that, you know, I may have been, you know, the Chris girl in the Chris Brown video, or, you know, the girl in the car with Fabulous, or even the girl, you know, in the bed with 50, or whatever it was, that, you know, I had more to me, and it means a lot to me. Even still when I watch it, I think it has value. People will always look at me as a lady, you know? And that just meant a lot to me, you know, because my mom didn't have to support me, even being young or not, you know what I mean? And doing what I wanted to do, but all she asked was that, you know, that I just presented myself properly. It was always important to me what the concepts were and who the director was and what wardrobe was and how I would look. I know how to be sexy in a way where I can give a director what he wants. You want curves? Great. You want my breast out? Fine, my stomach has to be covered. Sexy is just showing, but still leaving a lot to wonder. If you feel completely comfortable in a thong and shaking your booty in front of the camera, go ahead. Because you know what? If you feel comfortable, it's gonna get across as you feeling comfortable, and that's gonna be sexy.
What's going on? Are you happy with everything? The store?
Yeah.
Sales have been great.
Yeah. Erica is one of the girls we hired at Dash, and I've known her for a couple years now from when my ex-boyfriend Scott and I used to come to Miami.
The whole reality experience, I think, definitely showed me that, I mean, day to day, believe it or not, our life can really, when you look back at it and you have someone taping you 24 hours, can really, like, put a lot of things in perspective for you.
I really have so much respect for Erica. She is a mom. She works so hard. It's really nice when friends can help each other out.
Overall, I have to say it was great. I mean, it definitely, I got to see myself through the third eye, and it helped me put myself in line and how I am, and sometimes too how things can be assumed and so on and so forth. And you can't always believe what you read and see sometimes, I would say, too. I learned that real quick.
just want to say I'm sorry. Like, I don't want you to think that I, like, took advantage of the fact you mean you being friends.
My friendship with Courtney means a lot to me.
Overall, it was just a great experience. The girls were really open at the same time. You know, we got to be around them, and they're very career oriented and working women. That kind of helped instill me too, being a young mom, that you can be a young mom and a woman and just do whatever it is you want. More ingredients to add to this gumbo, and I'm excited, you know, because I set out and I left home early, and all I knew is that I had a dream, and I'd always known what I wanted to be, whether it is modeling or music or acting or seeing me on a commercial or picking up an issue because I have a spread, or even better yet, I'm on a front cover. Everything I've ever aspired to do in my career has definitely been my destiny. And at the end of the day, I can say I lived out my dream. I am Erica Mena.